Such epic music! Yes! Hi guys, Vex here! And in this video, I'll be walking you through your first day in Space Engineers. Space Engineers is a sandbox space building game, and for the new player, it can be pretty overwhelming and confusing. So I'm going to show you the basics and teach you how to survive and not die horribly when you're starting out in this game. Alright, let's try the Lone Survivor start. And I've already got it configured, and I'm just going to get in the game. Alright, so we are now in Space Engineers. Alright, so I'm just going to walk you through the basic steps to start off properly in this game. First off, you want to hit G, open up your toolbar, right-click all this stuff here, get it out of the way. You won't need it. Go ahead and get yourself your hand drill, your grinder, and your welding torch. Walk on over to your medical bay and hit V to go into third person. Use that medical bay, it's T, and pick yourself out a color, because if you're going to survive in this game, you may as well do it with style. I'm going to choose a nice dark red for myself. That's what I like to rock. V. Alright, now we're going to go back over Mia. In the bottom left corner, you will notice that I have health and I have energy. X is my jetpack. You control it with WASD, W-A-S-D. Q and E rotates yourself. C by default is crouch, and that lowers yourself. However, I rebind it to shift because I like it better. Space goes up and down, so you have W-A-S-D, Q and E for rolling, up and down with space, and C by default. I suggest rebinding it to shift, to be honest with you. So those are your basic jetpack controls. The inertial dampener is controlled with Z, and that basically, if I turn it off and I go, I'm going to keep going forever until I run into something. If the dampeners are on, it will automatically stop me relative to stations and asteroids, which are always sitting still, and I do not believe they can move. Alright, so the way you get your energy back, if your energy runs out, it's bad news for you. The way you get it back is plugging into a cockpit on a ship or station that's got some energy. Alternatively, you can come over here and use T, hold down the T key on the med bay, and get your health and energy back there. If you've ever played Minecraft or Terraria, and you're familiar with the concepts of beds, that's what these basically are. If you're not familiar with beds, then the medical terminals and Space Engineers are your personal respawn point. If you're playing multiplayer, every person needs their own medical room to respawn at. As of this patch right now, they are not shared. Each person needs to put down their own medical bay. And what I mean by put down is you press G, you go find the medical bay right there. Each player needs to come in and put down one of these blueprints on the ground and then build it. It doesn't matter if your friend finishes building it for you, but you need to be the person to actually place it down first. That binds it to you. That registers it as your medical room. That's pretty important. All right. So when you start this game off, let's come over back here to the cockpit. All right. Bottom right corner. Brief information readout about the station it spawns us on. We don't have very much. There's one number here that's really important. Fuel time, 38 minutes. Okay, so we checked our fuel time. Let's hop out of the cockpit, go over here to the nuclear reactor. Default key is K to open this. I have bound this. I have remapped K to my mouse 4 button, which I click with my thumb. I find it speeds up playing the game a whole lot. The panel here is accessed with also K. They're both K here. Yeah, T doesn't do anything. You use T on the medical bay, and you also use T on cockpits. Yeah. All right. So in the nuclear reactor, which you start off with, you have fuel. You have uranium ingots. All right, that's your fuel. That's slowly going down. This is going to last us for 38 minutes. And when you're in survival, your very first priority is to find uranium. You do not have long. This runs out a lot faster than you think. But there's a trick here that we can use to help us out. So go ahead, hop in that cockpit, hit K, bring this up. Go ahead and turn off the gravity generator. Yeah, I know. And turn off the... Actually, that should be it. Let me take a look here. Okay, our fuel time, by turning off the gravity generator, our fuel time went from 38 minutes up to 2 days. So we now we have a lot more time to work with. And as you can see, if you ever need to come back and refuel your suit, re-energize your suit, you can come to either this cockpit or the medical bay over there. They're both still turned on. So now that you've got some breathing room by turning off that gravity generator, I will say this. Let's go back in here. Look at this real quick. The control panel controls all the pieces of the station. These are all pieces of the station. If you want to actually rename the station, this is the beacon. You see that glowy yellow thing right up there? That's a beacon. And beacons show off the name they're given. So this can be Vex's tutorial station for survival. See? And that's going to change the name of it, as you can see there. All right, so we've got ourselves a little bit of breathing room. What I could have done is actually leave the gravity generator on, turn it down to 10 Gs, and then shrink the field here. The original power input was like 567 kilowatts. Now it's down to 40. So what that has done is my fuel time went from 38 minutes to 8 hours. That still bought a lot of time for myself. And if I turn my jetpack off with X, you can see I can still run around on here just like I could earlier. And the lower gravity really doesn't impact me too much. Although you can see a little bit of a difference there. Actually, lower gravity might be a good idea all the time, because if you're flying around and you just turn your jetpack off, if you're at 1x gravity, you can smack into the ground here on the station and hurt yourself. So, all right. I didn't know if I would get one of those. I have cargo ships turned on. What you see right up there is a ship. Those are basically NPC ships. There's not actually any NPCs, but they're other entities in the game that aren't you. Therefore, I'm going to call them NPCs, non-playable characters. Should I technically call them NPS, non-playable ships? Well, basically, these ships that come into your system are fodder for you to pirate. And I'll go ahead and tell you, a private sail is one of the ships that doesn't have any gun turrets on it that shoot back at you. So private sails are great to go and hijack. And I was going to cover mining, but you know what? Because that private sail's right there, I'm going to deviate from the script I had for this video, and I'm going to go get that private sail. I'm just going to show you how to pirate that thing. So here is one method. Turn your jetpack on, face your destination, that private sail, turn off the inertial dampener, accelerate to 111 meters per second. It doesn't take long at all. Speed, 70, 80, 90, 100, maxed out. All right, let go of the W key, and you can see my thing has stopped thrusting. So the reason I have the inertial dampeners off is that now I can face any direction, and as long as I don't mess with my thrusting, I'm going to keep traveling in the direction I was thrusting in originally. And that saves your fuel. Same principle works for spaceships too. So we're going to come over here to this private sail, and at about 500 meters from it, I'm going to turn on the dampeners again, and I'll show you why in a second here. So I'm going to get close enough to this thing to where I get a good visual on it. All right. Dampeners back on. We're going to come to a complete stop. Okay, I am stopped in space right now. I'm going to turn the dampeners off again. I used them basically as a brake. The dampeners make a great brake. Now I'm going to start accelerating towards this private sail. Okay. So basically, when you pirate this vehicle, what you want to do is make it your world. You want to be still relative to it. So I'm coming in here and I'm using the WASD keys to control my acceleration and braking. And as you can see, I am technically moving right now. You see my station over there, my station is stopped. That space station is still, but as you can see, I'm moving because it's getting closer to us right now. But relative to this spaceship, this private sail here, I'm still. And so, because, you know, space is, everything is relative. You and I, you watching this video right now, are hurtling through space at, how fast does the Earth move? Something like 34,000 miles an hour through space? Something like that? I don't remember. But it's really, really fast. But the point is, you get yourself nice and still compared to this private sail. And that way, you can very easily come in the back here. You want to go to the back of the vehicle. And right here, you want to take out your grinder. And with your grinder out, you can start busting into the spaceship. You're breaking into it. It's like a heist. All right. Now, once you're at the door, you can hit T to open the door. And look at that right there. That's a cockpit. We're going to hop in the cockpit. Got to work around the chair there. Okay. We're now in control of the private sail. I'm going to turn the dampeners on to bring it to a stop. And at this point, we can orient it towards the platform that we started on. And I'm going to turn the dampeners off now. I use the dampeners as a brake. I'm going to turn them off so that we can start accelerating and I can let go of the thruster and we'll keep accelerating. The dampeners will always try to stop you when you have them on, and they make for excellent brakes. My advice is that if you're in a ship or if you're in a suit and you're moving forwards and you try to brake, don't try to go backwards. Just turn your dampeners on. From my experience, they are a much more effective braking mechanism than your actual thrusters. So this private sail is very sluggish, and it's really not too useful, I think, without modification. As it stands right now, it's a very sluggish cargo ship, and that's basically it. Now, this is going to take a little bit of time to get back to the station because this ship is kind of sluggish. So I'm just going to cut the footage here and we'll skip ahead to the station. Okay, we're back at the station. I'm turning the dampeners on. We are slowing down to a stop. And I'm just going to park this thing somewhere. It does not have landing gear on. Landing gear are those little shoe things. There's some large size landing gear right there in the middle of the station where that red block is. But I'm going to use a combination of key presses here to maneuver this into a nice maybe parked position. In fact, to tell you what we're going to do, we're going to swing the butt side around and hold. You can hold down Alt in third person to pan the camera around, which is what I just did there. I used Alt to do that. And we're going to back this thing up and good enough. All right, so we have it parked where we want to. I'm going to make sure the dampeners are on. I'm going to wait a second. It's completely still. Now I am going to actually hit Y to power it off. And I'm going to hit T to hop out. And then we're just going to get out of here. It's a little bit of a tight fit with this doorway here. Come on. Come on. There we go. All right. So that is our brand new spanking ship. And I'll go ahead and tell you, if you were low on fuel, you can come around here to the bottom of the ship, open this door, and there's a reactor here. It's actually got some uranium inside of it. You can take that and go back to your station here and put it into your reactor. Do a little double click here, and that puts it in there. By the way, double click is the entire stack. Shift click is 100, and control click is 10, in case you ever want to transfer items. Alright, so we have plenty of fuel now, so that's one way of acquiring early fuel. I wanted to show you mining first, but that private sail just fell into our laps and I had to take, you know, the opportunity there. So we have 9 days of fuel time now. It's fantastic. All right, let's say you don't have those ships turned on, or you can't find a private sail to pirate. And by the way, with the grinder here, you can come in and start cutting the ship up, and you can cut pieces off of it with your grinder. And when you look at it, when you get close, it'll tell you what you'll get. You can get steel plate here. That red line on the bar there is the functional line. If it's above that red bar, the object is functional, and if it's below it, then it's lost functionality. So this thruster, for example, here. Wow, that thruster is actually cut down all the way already. I don't remember doing that. Let me take a look at another thruster. Yeah, there we go. So I can cut into this, and I've cut off some of the steel plate that was on it, but this thruster is still functional. And it's still functional until it breaks that red line right there. Now it just stopped working. So, but you can see the components, they go into my inventory. If it's your first time playing the game, I recommend using the 10x multipliers for every the refinery, the inventory space, and the assembling. Use the 10x multipliers. If you leave it at realistic or 1x on the world settings, it's very grindy and slow, and I wouldn't recommend it. Okay, so let's say you spawned on here, and you're not into piracy, or these ships don't spawn for your world. You have that option turned off. What you need to do is you need to take out your drill, and you're on the clock. Remember, you know, you don't start with very much uranium. So you need to get on your jetpack, head over here to your first asteroid. Well, when you have your drill in your hand, it functions as an ore detector. It's not very good, but it beats nothing. And that's basically what you have now. You have nothing. So take out your drill. I found this easier to do in third person. And you need to fly around and look for uranium deposits. They appear as a charcoal-y looking black deposit. It really looks like charcoal, honestly. But let me take a look around here. Try and work quickly, but don't accidentally bump your head and kill yourself. If you die, it does seem that your inventory gets wiped, so the death penalty is you lose your inventory. So try to avoid dying. Now, uranium and all the other ores are actually spawned randomly. Uranium is somewhat rare, and it is no guarantee that it will actually be on your starter asteroid. Let me look around. Let me keep looking. I'm doing this live on camera for you. I have no prior knowledge where the ore is, so you're seeing me search live without a script, without knowing if I'll find any at all. So I am just looking as fast as I can, flying around this. Really helps to get good at judging distance in third person. And flying like this. I'm really not finding any. And this is why I would suggest turning that gravity generator off. If you only have a small fraction of uranium to start the game with, just turn off the non-vital stuff in your space station to conserve that power so that you can use it to recharge your suit while you search for uranium. And then once you've found a reasonable stockpile of the stuff and you find the uranium ore and then refine it into ingots and then stick those ingots in your nuclear reactor, then you've got some breathing room to start turning on the stuff in your station. And you can mess around with it. Well, it looks like I'm really not finding uranium at the start here. Let me keep looking. And if I can't find any on this starting asteroid, what I'll end up having to do is going to another asteroid and hoping I can find some. Alright. No, I don't really... Let me back up real quick and see if I can just visually spot any on the surface. It's going to be a black charcoal-looking deposit, and I don't think I see any. It can be sometimes hard to tell with the shadows. Like right there, is that uranium or is that just shadow on the surface of the stone? Is there any uranium here? No, so it's just shadow. That can be kind of tough sometimes. Alright, so there's no uranium here. If that happens to you, in your single-player world. Now, that doesn't mean there's not uranium deeper in this asteroid. Very well could be. But there's no uranium that I have easily found with the poor quality range on the hand drill. So what we're going to do is we're going to come back here. And this is actually great that I had difficulty finding it, because this shows you what to do if you don't find any uranium. So we're going to restock our energy. All right. We have a beacon that'll show us the way home. So that's cool. Now, before I head out here, I want to cover something else. There are solar panels on this ship here. Solar panels have very cruddy output compared to nuclear power plants, but what they are good for is if you have some solar panels, what you can do is I'm going to come in this ship here. Now, you'll remember I took the fuel out of this reactor. So the only thing this ship has left for power are the solar cells. So I'm going to hop in here, and I'm going to turn the reactors back on. You'll notice that I can't really move too well. It says my power usage is 3,000%. I'm only generating 21 kilowatts. Actually, what I will do right now is turn the solar cells towards the sun. You'll notice the little pips there, those green pips. They actually change to give you a quick visual representation of the efficiency of the solar cells. As you can see, I've turned the ship into darkness, and I've made it really inefficient for the power cells. And actually, this is a big problem, because I have actually turned them to such low power that I cannot rotate the ship anymore. So if you're ever in a solar-powered vehicle, and that happens, you actually need to bump into it and try to turn it yourself here. Let me see if I can boop myself into the wing here. The side panel here. Push! Push, rotate, come on! Am I rotating it at all? I turned the... Come on, go! Looks like it's actually not... Well... Yeah, so a word of warning there. Don't ever accidentally rotate the thing to where you can't get power to rotate anymore. Let's see. Reactors. Wow, so I've actually managed to Oh no, the solar panels are producing some power. They're producing 453 watts right now. Yeah, that's not too good. But basically my point here is that even very low power solar panels can still provide energy to recharge your suit. So a ship like this, like the Sail, even without fuel in the reactor, you could still have the power to recharge your suit, unless you intentionally turn it sideways and get it oriented where the sunlight can't hit either the top or bottom panels. Look at that. I really goofed that up, didn't I? Okay, so back to drilling. So you don't find any uranium on your starting asteroid. What now? Should you restart the world? No, you're honestly probably okay. So you can use this beacon to orient yourself and always find your way home. It's a great thing to have. I'm going to head to this asteroid right here. I saw it. I'm going to turn off my dampeners. We're going to fly over here. And the thing is, your suit actually gets around the area pretty quick. As you can see, we are... What is this? How far is this? About 2K? Yeah, something like that. Let's use the dampeners to slow ourselves down. Dampeners off again. And then on to brake one more time. Yeah, we're about 2K away. Okay, so here's a second asteroid. Now, this one, let's go see if we can find some uranium. Hopefully this one will be more charitable to us. Let's get into third person. I'm going to hit L to turn my lights on. Let's look around, try and find some. Iron, okay. Iron is certainly nice. What is that right there? Is that it? Is that some uranium? Oh, that's cobalt. Well, that's silver, cobalt, no. Well, those are nice. We are not really interested in any of that. We are looking for uranium. Let's use that mouse wheel to zoom out a bit here. Iron. We're looking for jet black patch on the surface. It doesn't have to be a surface deposit, although if you're just flying around... Wait a minute, what's that right there? Is that uranium or is that shadow? That shadow again. What did I tell you? All right, let's try and find some uranium here. Okay, we're at 82% power. Zooming around. That's cobalt, silver, lots of iron. Well, that's a very, that's a good, wait, what is that right there? Is that uranium? No, that's just stone. Okay, that's just a goofy looking shadow. Yeah, that's just a goofy looking shadow. Alright, I thought that was uranium though. My bad. Okay. Let's see. No, I don't see any. I see iron. Alright. Well, it looks like this asteroid is going to be a dud. Now again, there could be uranium inside this thing, but our drill, our hand drill, really does not have the power to scan deeply inside this thing. It really doesn't. So any deposit we locate with a hand drill is going to have to be closer to the surface. Magnesium. Iron. Let's see. Nope, not seeing any. Alright, this asteroid, I'm going to call this asteroid a dud for now. And let's go to another one. Let's go fly over to, I don't know, maybe this small asteroid. See if we can find any uranium quickly on the surface here. Again, we're looking for jet black patches on the surface. Looks like this thing might just be iron. Yep, I'm not really seeing any black patches. Okay, what about this chunk of metal right here? What do you have in you, sir? Hello? Uranium? Uranium? We need... Oh, there we go. Okay. All right. We found something. All right. So it's 25 meters down into the surface. Now, to get an accurate depth measurement, let's get here. All right. 13. That's fine. Looks like it's about 13, 14, 12 here. Okay, so I'm just going to... All right, so with the hand drill, left-click digs, right-click destroys. Now, if you right-click, you're not going to get any drops. But right-click is useful for quickly digging into stone. This right here, let me left-click. I'm going to left-click here. All right, so that's stone. Did I get any chunks knocked out I can grab? Any big chunks? Oh, let me get some stone here. There's a piece. Let me go pick some up. I'm going to get to it. Hit T to pick up stone. T to pick up stone. Check my inventory. There's the stone. Stone is useful for gravel. The only thing I think gravel is useful for is... Well, I can't see production menus from without being on a station or a large ship. But gravel is useful for making nuclear reactors, and that's about it. All right, so I'm going to right-click, and you're going to use the destroy. Destroy, 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 destroy. Right-click, destroy. We're getting close. There we go. That's it right there. That black patch, that's uranium. All right, so we've used right-click to quickly eat through this relatively useless stone. Now we're going to get some uranium. Now, you noticed when I mined the stone, it flew out with quite some vigor into the void of space. Once you get more inside a tunnel, the tunnel walls kind of help keep this stuff trapped. So I can dig for a bit and then turn around and see and try to grab this stuff as it floats out. Now there's another tactic you can use. You don't have to hit T, you can hold down T, and holding down T, there's uranium right there. If you hold down T, it'll pick it up right as soon as it gets in your crosshairs. So by holding down T, hold down T and left click, hold down left click, you can sometimes get some of this stuff as it comes out. Now whether or not you want to just do this and only take the uranium that you actually manage to grab right as it comes out, maybe a personal preference matter there. If I turn around, there is certainly uranium behind me floating around in space. I guess it kind of depends on if you want to try to chase it around in space or if you just want to take whatever you can get easily. Do you want the low-hanging fruit or do you want to try to chase it all down? I don't know. But I'm not going to chase any down right now. Let's see just how much I can easily get by holding down T and left click at the same time. We're going to get the easy uranium that I can just kind of easily grab here. Alright. Uranium refines at about, I think it's 144 to 1. So 144 kilograms of ore is going to give you 1 kilo of actual uranium. Let's reorient myself so I don't want to get disoriented. That can be dangerous when you need to quickly get out of a location. We're pretty deep in here. Now, one mining technique that I sometimes use, and I'll show it off. I think I've got the energy for it. I will grab. Let's see what I did to get. Okay, we got. We're gonna end up with 1,000 kilos of ore by the time we get out of here. All right. Let me get out of here. Come on, turn. There we go. Don't get stuck and hung up in here. Let me grab all of this on the way out. Okay, get that one, and that one, and that one. Alright, how much did we make out with? Yeah, we got over 1,000. I think that's pretty good. Pretty good haul. If you're playing on realistic, you're not going to have the inventory space for that much. Let me show you this mining technique. Let me go back to some of this iron, I think. There's a piece of iron ore. Alright, so here's a mining technique you can use. Let's say you see a patch of ore on the surface, right? There it is. I could come in. Oh, look at that. There's uranium right there. I could start mining it right now, but that's going to have stuff flying off into space. Now, to be fair, you're really not going to be using your hand drill too long because you can get a small ship with a drill attachment on it, specifically that thing right there. And that is so much better. So much better than the hand drill. Like, super duper better than the hand drill. But okay. Let's say you're using the hand drill, and here's a pocket of iron. Instead of coming right into it, go to the stone beside it, and what you're going to do is basically you're going to make an L shape. Come in here. Alright, so there's the iron right over there. And then we're going to come in at an angle. Oh, look at that. I struck uranium. And the point of doing this is now we're beside the deposit of iron and uranium. And instead of coming into it from the top, we're going to start drilling into the side of it. And by making an indentation into the side here, we're going to hook around, and that hook shape, as we drill into the side, like this, see that hook shape keeps all the ore in this tunnel you're making, and it keeps it from flying out into space. So my little tip there is if you're going to dig with a hand drill, dig beside the pocket and then turn sideways and dig into it from the side. That'll keep more of the ore inside your tunnel and a bit less of that ore from flying out into space. Okay, we're at 26% fuel. We need to get back before we run out of energy and die. Alright, so we're going to fly back, and remember, dampener on, look at destination, dampener off, accelerate towards destination. Once you reach your max cruising speed of 111-ish, although honestly we might not even have much time to get to it, no we're not. By the time I hit 111, we're going to be right on top of the station anyway. But accelerate towards destination. Once you're near the destination, dampeners on to decelerate, and you're good to go. And it's that easy to get around in your spacesuit. Hit zero, get our hands empty, Don't want to accidentally, you know, drill something. Get back to the station, X to jetpack off, land, and come over to the refinery. Okay. Now, thankfully, the refinery has already been linked here to the assembler, and it's sitting on top of it. In Space Engineers, these yellow doors can connect things and share parts. Now, the reactor is not connected, so it's not sharing anything. But what I could do is use these conveyor blocks here to actually connect stuff. I'm not going to go into that. This video is just about the very basics of survival, and I want to teach you the two ways to get established. First, we covered piracy, and we stole the uranium from the ship, and we can grind the ship down with our grinder to get parts. Now, I think I do have some of those parts. I do have some of these parts here in my inventory. That's great. All right, so I'm going to come into the... All right, hold on a sec. Let's use our HEV suit terminal here. This really reminds me of Half-Life. I can almost hear the sound effect in my head from Half-Life when you use the wall terminals. The brrrr, 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 brrrr. You know that sound? There we go. We are maxed out, charged up, and healthy again. Cool. Alright, so pop up in the refinery. You can double-click the stuff in here. Definitely going to do the uranium first, followed by the iron and the stone. Alright. And as you can see, the refinery starts to chew this stuff down into uranium ingots. I think this is going to give us... Oh, man, I can't do this math on camera right in my head. It's 144 to... Why am I trying to do this? I'm not sure. Well, 10... would be 1,044. I don't know, but it's gonna give us some uranium. Oh my gosh. And so we can take that out of the reactor, or out of the refinery, and stick it in our reactor. All right, and there you go. That's it. That's fuel for your station, and that'll help you power up. If I wanted to, I could take my grinder and grind down the solar panels here and take them off this ship, and then build some solar panels on this station here. Stick them somewhere, probably somewhere maybe on this side. Maybe build a steel, just build a tower on the corner, and just build this right on up, and out of the way, build it high and out of the way, and then put the solar panels here on the side. Maybe on the top, like that, or something. When you go to place a block, you get this nice little menu in the top right. This was disorienting for me at first until I just took some time to study it. Imagine yourself looking at this solar panel here, and imagine yourself reaching out and grabbing it, and then the way you move your hands, if you correspond that. So if I want to take this thing and rotate it counterclockwise, I'm going to hit insert like that. And if I wanted to take this thing and twist it with my right arm going forward and twist it to my left, that would be page down like that. And then delete would go the opposite way. So, you know, I could stick that down there and strip the solar panels off that ship to make solar panels for my station. Basically, what that's going to do is offset idle power usage. You know, it's not going to be enough to really power the refinery and assembler, but what it can do is maybe power your gravity generator and give you enough power to research your suit so that if you do bottom out on uranium, you can at least keep your suit charged up with enough power to let you explore and mine more uranium with a hand drill. So I thought the solar panels when I first got in the game would be like a replacement for the uranium power. Maybe if you had a ridiculous number of them, but for the most part they're like backup power to help you charge your suit. Maybe run gravity generators, maybe, and that's about it. Alright, so into the assembler. The assembler is where we can produce stuff, and I'm going to go ahead and throw the stuff in there, into the assembler that we found. This is stuff we ground off the private sail ship that we pirated. Now, okay. I'm going to cover this too because it was not very intuitive for me when I first started this game. When you go to build an item, you basically pick a blueprint of the item from this menu here. Put it on your bar. Then, you need one of the bottom item in the list here. Let me go find something more complicated than this steel block. Let me find a... actually, a solar panel would be a great example. Okay, so if I want to go ahead and place this blueprint into the world, I need one of the bottom component. For this example, that's the construction component. I need one construction component, and that would actually let me place down a blueprint to be finished. So let's go look in here. There we go. I've got a construction component in there. I'll hold down control to take 10 of them. So now, as you can see, the outline turns green, and I can place down up to 10 of these solar panel blueprints if I wanted to. Now, take out the welder, and I go here. You'll see that it has, if you look here, bottom right corner, 1 out of 7 construction components placed, then a list here of all the other stuff it needs. So that needs to be in your inventory, and you start welding, and it deposits them there, and you can start building it. Now, it'll let you build up for a little while if you don't have everything, but eventually to finish this, I'm going to need all the stuff in there. So that's an example of how the building works, and yeah, I'm not going to take the time to do this because it would take quite some time. I'm in fact going to use the grinder to reclaim all of this. There's no penalty for grinding down. It's 100% efficient to reclaim all of this. You get everything you put into it back. You don't lose stuff. Okay, so let's say you don't feel like mining. Let's say you want materials. You can pirate ships and just take the materials directly and put them to use immediately, or you can go to the control panel and go to production, disassembly, and disassemble everything using your assembler, and that turns it back into, as you can see here, it's turning it back into the raw materials, which are being stored in the assembler for use later. Okay, there we go. Skip ahead a little bit, and it's eaten all of these materials, and we've turned it into iron, cobalt, gold, and platinum. And our refinery's actually gotten done and has taken the ore we took and turned it into uranium and iron and gravel. I'm going to go ahead and take the uranium, and we're going to stick that uranium right on in here into the reactor. Alright. So I'm going to take this stuff out of the refinery and then put it back into the assembler here. Like that. This right up here, these two, you can pull up player inventory and connected inventories. What this is for is for easier dragging and dropping. Like if I just had this and I wanted to drag something from the assembler to the refinery, I'd actually have to move down, and you'd have to do something like drag it and then hold down with your left mouse button here and then use your middle finger to rotate the mouse wheel to move that bar. And let's be honest, it's kind of awkward to do. That requires some dexterity. So if you didn't happen to have a mouse wheel, you click that, you can see a duplicate of these menus. Move this one down. Now you can see the refinery, and now you can just drag it like that. So that's what that's for. Production. All right. So here we have the... Let's go back to assembling. I'll actually disassemble all those. Go back to assembling. Oh, it stops when you change the menu. Okay. Go to assembling. Alright. So, what is this? If I click this, is that going to make a light armor block? If I click that, did it make a light armor block? What's going on? It's making steel plate. No, it doesn't actually make the item. What it does is, if you look at your blueprints here, what the assembler is going to do, if you click on one of these items, it's a shortcut to basically make everything required to build the blueprint. It doesn't build the item, it spits out the ingredients that the blueprint of the item is going to require from you. Make sense? It was kind of hard for me to understand that at first, but then I was like, oh, okay, now it makes sense. So, look, something like this, if I order it to build a, small blocks, tools, there's all the tools. If I just order, it does actually build the tools. These are things that actually do get built. But this stuff, it gives you the components that you need to assemble the blueprint at the location in which you placed it. So if I wanted, say, build a passenger seat, I click the passenger seat, click it. It's going to spit out all the components necessary to actually build a passenger seat. So I go to the inventory and I grab this stuff, and I would go to the passenger seat and place it down in the world, take out the welder, and then start welding it. And as you can see, it's man, that welder's bright. The progress bar starts filling up. Now, here's a one last tip I think I have to give to you. And there's a bunch of other stuff in the game that I could cover, like how the landing gear here works. I'm not going to go into that. I'm not going to cover ships. I'm just going to cover the very basics of getting started, because this video has probably gone on long enough. You can figure the rest out, you know, trial and error. At this point, I've taught you enough that you can stay alive and experiment on your own without starving to death. Well, this game's version of starving to death. All right, check this out. Check this out. This is kind of cool. I'm going to use my grinder, and I'm actually going to reclaim this back down under the functional line. You see how that red line there is actually pretty low? You see how the passenger seat requires interior plate, construction component, and then more interior plate. All right, this is where it gets cool. I'm going to go back to the assembler. I'm going to get rid of the construction components and the steel plate out of my inventory, and in fact, I'm just going to roll out with 11 interior plating. All right, check this out. I'll use another example chair here. Boom. That's got 1 out of 10 interior plates, but I've got 10 left in my inventory here. I'm going to start poking at it with the welder. We've got 10 out of 10 of the interior plates. We just crossed the functional line. We haven't even put any construction components on the chair yet, but watch this. It works. It's fully functional. It's recharging my energy right now. It doesn't let me access the... does not let me access the control terminal, since it's just a passenger chair. All you can really do with it is sit in it and let your friend drive you around and recharge your suit. Actually, I found that in a multiplayer server, these chairs make great AFK chairs to go into, because you won't die in them since they constantly refill your energy, and you can safely go AFK, and you're linked to the chair, and you can't get knocked around. So, AFK chairs, basically. But let's say you don't have any construction components. Let's say all you have are 10 of the interior walls. Yeah, interior plate. Well, that's all it takes to make a functional chair. The rest is more or less armor. That's basically what you're making here. If you keep welding this past the line, you're making it more durable. That's basically it. So this is true for actually a lot of items. You can make them functional without fully building them. I'm going to say armoring them. You can get them functional without armoring them completely. Like thrusters, for example. Thrusters, as you can see, I'm going to take out the grinder. Look at this. I'm going to start grinding and taking away stuff. Basically, the thrusters, I've removed the steel plate and I've removed those construction components, but the thruster is still fully functional. It's still above that red line there. So you can make thrusters like this without those final steel plates and without those construction components. It's not going to be as durable. If it gets hit once, it's probably going to break, but it is functional. So if you're in a desperate survival situation, that's something to keep in mind. If you don't have the material to finish something, you might be able to get away with only partially finishing it. Well, anyway, I think that's about all there is to teach you as far as the very, very basics of this game go. From this point onwards, you can start experimenting by yourself, and you won't run out of energy. You know how to replace your energy from two separate sources. You know how to mine, and you know how to pirate these defenseless private sails. So that's the very, very basics of the game. There are other ships. There's more ore out there, but have fun unlocking those mysteries for yourself. Fair warning though, if it has military in the name, it's gonna shoot you with bullets and you're So you might want to put some of this stuff on your ship before you go after that stuff. Anyway, thank you guys very much for watching. Toss me a like if you found this helpful, and I'll see you guys in other Space Engineer videos. Until then, take it easy. I'm here again. One last thing. If you get really desperate in a survival situation on this starting map, you can grind down these steel catwalks here. They don't do anything, really. They're just there for looks. You can grind those down, and you can grind down these landing gear struts. These are helpful for locking a ship down when you make a ship, but you only really need one of them. Technically, you don't need any of them, but they do help out a lot. But you can get away with just one of these left, so if you want some components and you're desperate, you can grind three of these down, and you can also grind down these catwalks. Anyway, take it easy.